mango, fluorescent pink flesh, blueberry, pee-pee. Finn.
So, we've seen the first challenger, now let's have a look at number two. So, Ms. Powell, thank you so much for coming onto my channel.
It's an absolute pleasure, Mr. Overton.
Thank you for agreeing to take this challenge.
Bring it on!
So the challenge is, I'm going to give you 30. These are from Living Plaza. They are just a $12 pack of colored pens. There are 30, and I want you to try and name each one without repeating any of the words.
I'm going to try my best. If I do make a mistake, mistakes are a proof that we're learning, so it's okay. All right. Grape. Indigo.
Come back.
Olive. Dark green. Peach. Blue. Blueberry.
That's allowed because it's part of a bigger word.
Uh-huh. Cobalt. Gray. Yellow. Lime. Amber. Orange. Burgundy. Eggplant.
Nice.
Brown. Leaves. Purple sweet potato. Or sweet potato. Mm-hmm. Oh, this one, huh? Blackboard. Eyeliner. This is a unique shade. Branches. This is my favorite. Mr. Overton. Love. I'll come back to it. Oh boy. I'll come back to it. Cherry blossom. Candy. This one could be spring.
Okay.
Rose. This one. I'll come back to it. This one could be midnight. It's a midnight. My shape. This again. Oh. Christmas.
Very nice.
And this.
It's doesn't kind of match. It's the shade that you're wearing almost.
Maybe I want to call it Mrs. Powell. Nice. Like Narwhal.
I accept. Okay. Well done, you got through.
I think I did really well, but it was really lovely to think about these colors, not as colors, but things in our life and our experiences and our relationships with things, with people. So I think it was great to associate colors with things around us.
Yeah. And that's really, it's a nice thing that we can do.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's what we do unknowingly. So putting in putting some conscious effort into thinking about it was really nice. Great reflective practice.
Well, thank you so much for taking that challenge.
Thank you for inviting me.
Good. Cut. Woo.